Game On or Oval? Hi, I'm Ray Williams. Ludi a big hit, but Cartel not playing after a TV interview. And Gaza socking it to Shensia and her manager Romish. What gives?
Four players at the board, the DJ, the producer, the gigolo, and the manager. The game going well until the manager claims too much credit for the gigolo. The DJ goes off to play by himself, while the producer tries to explain himself, and everybody is scared of the fans.
Bad we bad, Gaza, bad we bad.
Ludi way more complicated than you'd think, but here's social media expert Dennis Brooks to try and untangle the knot.
Apparently, it was a song that was recorded originally as a solo, and it was made into a duet featuring, of course, Shensia. There are some issues that have been raised, and we heard the explanation given by Shensia some weeks ago, saying that, look, it is Vybz Kartel featuring Shensia. However, she's doing the verses and Vybz Kartel is doing the chorus, which makes it sound like Vybz Kartel is the feature. These are things that management of both artists should have sorted out in the beginning. Who is featuring? Whose song it is? We saw, of course, a brief clip of Shensia trying to explain the situation and saying that it was no case of stealing the song. And then we saw another brief clip, which seemed like it was maybe from one of her social media pages, a very short rant that I don't think did her very well or won her many points in this whole tit-for-tat or in this Ludi game, so to speak. She threw the dice, and eventually people were saying that that didn't sound very good. Then Romish came and did an interview or did some damage control, which was much better. And immediately people were saying Romish should have come out from early and dealt with this situation. It's a song that was on the wane by now, and now the whole controversy has caused it to shoot up in terms of views, plus Kartel's treatment of the song, his solo treatment of the song. It shot away, out doing a song that was doing well. Everybody was talking about Infrared at the time.
So everybody benefits.
I think everybody benefits, and I'm beginning to wonder if this is not smart PR to keep this relationship and this song going. I think that it's manufactured beef. To an extent, Kartel needs these kinds of controversies because it's what keeps him relevant while he's in prison. I don't know when he recorded this original version of the song, this quote-unquote original version of the song. I don't know if it was pre-2011 when he became incarcerated. I can't say, but what I can say is that we are talking about him, and he finds a way every month or every 2 months to keep us talking about him. It's a win for Kartel. It's already been a win for Shensia. I don't think anybody's taking the L in this one.
Ludi now licensed to VP Records by producer Elvis Redwood, currently in the US. Redwood uploaded a video on YouTube declaring that Kartel got his cut and that he'd done nothing wrong.
The only time money mentioned in the deal was when Romish paid $500,000 to shoot the video. When Romish paid Red Boom for mix the song, see? And when VP lies to the song, give back Romish the money for the video, give me a portion of the money for the song, and me decide to make a Kartel a part of my own. And me make it reach him. VP never give me two check, one for you and one for Kartel, and I take two of them. Me get my check, Johnny Wanda get Kartel check. What you blame me for? To put Shensia up on a Kartel song without Kartel permission, me never in the past need Kartel permission to put nobody up on a song. We just know the do's and the don'ts. I'm always do the do's. See? I'm putting a young artist on a Kartel song was never an issue. And if it was an issue, I released a song from October. Why I know Kartel has said? If a Kartel, why I know Kartel has said? My song was never a color.
Kartel's common law wife Shorty taking to social media to heap scorn on Redwood, accusing him of dishonesty. Does she have a point?
We take for granted a few things in Jamaican music. One of them is that if you are given permission to record a song, then you have the right of distribution to do whatever you want. You really need to secure the rights from the holders, which is one, the performer on the song, and two, you need to also get it from the songwriter. Now, in the event that you have joint ownership of the song, You know, so some people who build the rhythm and some people build the lyrics. In that event, you can assign, either one of you can assign the use of the song to other people as long as there is fair compensation.
So Elvis, as a producer, still has to secure clearance from Cartel before he puts Shensia on the song.
Technically and legally, that is what should be done.
Doesn't this illustrate that once you're in prison, you're really not calling the shots? People can get away with doing whatever it is they want to do.
Well, that's assuming, of course, that this is not one big publicity stunt, as some people are alleging.
Do you think it's a publicity stunt?
I don't know. But the fact is, I think this song is getting significant rotation and attention. And I think, you know, it's fabulous for the song.
Cartel fans letting fly at the world boss's enemies, real or perceived. Others wondering what the fuss is all about.
Shensia, no do nothing wrong. You know what I mean? It's just some misorganization with the management staff. As you can see, you know, your Vibes Cartel, disrespect her. You know, you should disrespect Vibes Cartel. Shensia, upcoming star. Business need new talent. Wanna stop eat her. Right now, the streets into her. You don't know the Gaza fans them. For them thing are normal, that's why I'm gonna try my best with them on the safe side. You see it, car. When them start got here, they easy.
The young youth, them true, them young, you know, saying she look nice, she attractive, so. Them young youth, them like her, so everybody's like, young youth, they gonna pick up here because she's a female and she really look good, so everybody has said, boy, they're not really bash her because a female, we're nice and thing, you know what I mean, sexy and everything.
When it comes to Vibes Cartel, are selectors careful about what they say?
Yeah, man, you know Vibes Cartel thing in Jamaica, him are the man, every selector a Vibes Cartel. Every selector rate Vibes Cartel and give him the credit there.
But even when they don't rate him, they have to watch what they say.
You still have to watch what you say because the fans have a wide fan base. So you don't want to get trapped. You want to keep everything on the safe side. So you don't say certain stuff. You keep it on a neutral level because it's a selector.
So you're not interested who wrote the song, if it's Cartel or whether Shensia had a couple lines
no,
in it.
No.
You just want
a good music.
You want to play the song.
We just want to play a good song.
Normally when I play Ludi before this controversial thing, normally I play the Ludi song, you know, it'll get like 2-3 pull up because it's hot. So you can play the Shensia like one time and then just play the Cartel version and just fit the two of them in the juggling. So you please Shensia fans and you please Cartel fans.
So the controversy is good for business?
Yeah, itself. Dancehall is a controversial place, so it's going to get a bigger boots.
The Shensia version still wearing the boots. The Straight Cartel reportedly pulled from his Vivo channel.